Alrighty, guys, welcome back to a brand new video. John Tavares, man. John Tavares going to the Leafs. Unbelievable. Who would have thought? Who would have thought? But you know what? We're going to see if he can do it. We're going to see if he can win the cup. You know what? I'm not just going to do it like, where the fuck is Toronto? I'm not just going to do it like no trades, no nothing. You know what? I'm going to do it the way I feel Toronto should handle this situation. You know what I mean? What do I show? What should I keep on? Sure. Fuck owner mode. Owner mode's fucking retarded. Like, with the fucking... I should stop. With the... what am I trying to say? Like, the revenue part of it? Like, hot dog prices? Who cares? Honestly. Like, no. Get away from me. Player morale? No. CPU trades? Yeah. Waivers? Yeah. Yeah. Alright, let's go down. Alrighty. It's gonna leave the settings the way they are. Actually, need to turn injuries down a bit, because if you leave them the way they are, kind of annoying. So, we're... Well, boys, here we go. The Toronto Maple Leafs. The new and improved Toronto Maple Leafs with John Tavares, Austin Matthews, Freddie Anderson, Morgan Riley, Jake the Snake Gardner, little Mitch Marner, a little Matt Martin, a little William Nylander. Man, you know what? This is a team, man. This is a fucking team. Sorry for swearing, but like, let's... Oh, I bet you I fucked it. I bet you I fucked it because I didn't fucking update the lines. Alright, boys. Well, I'm going to be right back. I forgot to do the fucking line updates, so I'm going to make another fucking thing here. And I'll be right back. John Tavares, Austin Matthews, Frederick Anderson. Here we go, boyos. Round two. Here we go. Owner mode off. Morale off. There we go. There we go. Alright, now let's jump. Gotta turn these fucking injuries down again. Because I can't be dealing with that every fucking 2 seconds. I'm gonna take the CPU down too, just to make it fair for them, though. That way they're not getting injured all the time and we're not. Because, you know. Keep it on. Alright, boyos, here we go. Oh. Now this, if I don't win the cup, I don't know. We're going to make some deadline moves, see if we can bolster up the roster a bit, see what Toronto's got in the works here, but you know what? We're winning the cup. I'm going to do everything in my power so we win this cup. Even if it means bringing in Ovechkin. Just kidding. We can't afford. John Tavares, baby! Oh yeah! The best. Like, he suffered in New York, and now he's going to thrive. He's going to play so good in Toronto, man. He's going to play so good in Toronto. You know what? I heard Mike Babcock, like, oh, these are what the lines are going to be. You know what? Fuck Mike Babcock. Johnny T is playing fucking top line minutes. Matthews, he's 19. You know what? Fucking play the second line minutes, bud. I got Johnny T now. You can fuck off. So, the lines are pretty much going to look like this. I guess Bozak's not on the team anymore. And neither is Komarov. So, I'm going to, like, trade those guys away. Actually, yeah. I think that's everybody. So, let's edit these lines now. Did the Toronto... No, they just signed Tavares. Nobody else. See, our defense is the scary part. Like, Connor Carrick and... Travis Dermott, like, never even heard of that guy in my life. Ron Hainsey, old man. Zaitsev, you know he's got some potential. Jake the Snake, gonna get him playing second line minutes with Ron Hainsey, just to, like, spread out the decor a little bit. Yeah. And then, like, is he a top four? Yeah. Top four. Top six. Top four. Yeah, like, this is how it's gonna look. What's Freddie Anderson looking like? 87? I like that. Alright, so... Oops. Special teams, we're going to... Oh, JVR is not a part of the team anymore. I got to send him to Philly. Give me 1 second here, boyos. Just so they can afford his cap or whatever. They're going to have to re-sign him to whatever they're doing anyway. Dale Weiss is irrelevant, so yeah. Now, boyos, what are we looking like? We got to sign John Tavares. We need to sign him to the 7 years at 11 mil. Offer extension. 7 years. I'm giving you a little more than you're asking, Johnny. I hope you like it. There you go, bud. And these guys all... Matthews is making his money, right? Yeah, he's gotta be. Alright, we'll advance a few days here. See what Johnny T has to say about his contract. Ah, there we go. Well, boyos, Johnny T is deciding to stay with the Toronto Maple Leafs. 7 years at $11 million. The man himself. Well, I guess it'll kick in next season, but there we go. Matthews, he's making his money. Or he's still on his minor league deal. So we'll have to give him a little bit of money, you know what I mean? So this is what the team's looking like. We're going to see how this rolls, see if we have to make any moves. Yeah, Kadri, you're going to be our third line center. Zach Hyman's going to play on the second line with Matthews and Marlowe. We've got Nylander and Marner up top. Actually, we're going to spread out the town a little bit. Always, you know what? I don't want to stunt their growth. Yeah, okay, this is what we're going to do. We're going to put Nylander with Matthews and Hyman. Kadri, Brown, depth? Yeah. Fourth. Is he a center? Who's good at face-offs? 60. 67. 60. You know what? It's the fourth line. Who cares? Dale Weiss is going to tear it up with Kadri and Brown. If we have to pick up... You know what? I wouldn't mind picking up a depth center and maybe a depth winger. Along with, like, another, like, top 6 D maybe. Maybe even a top 4 and drop Hainsey down to the 4th. Or the 3rd line, I mean. And then we can slap Jake Gardner on the 1st line with Riley. And then pick up someone like... Maybe Chris Tanev from the Canucks or Edler, maybe. One of those two guys wouldn't mind picking up. You know what? They'd be a force. I'm pretty sure they only make like 4 or 5 mil each. So, like, I'm pretty sure we can afford that. You know what? A pick. You know what? They're probably going to trade a pick at the deadline for their Stanley Cup woes. So, we are too. So, we're going to sim to the regular season here, boys. Probably go undefeated. Ah, we already lost one. Yeah, but... You guys let me know if how you think Toronto's going to be doing in the playoffs or in the regular season this year. They going to win a cup? Like, I think they are. Like, you know what? As much as I love my Canucks, I'd just be happy to see a Canadian team bring the cup home. That's all I want to see, really. Well, boys, here we go. Start of the 2018 season? 2017 season? I guess the season already happened, but Caps won the cup, Ovi won the cup, but now Johnny T's going to win his. We're going to sim all the way to the trade deadline, and then we're going to make our moves from there. Unless we start going negative and things are looking bad, then we're going to make a move, but I'm pretty sure I got the Leafs the way the Leafs are, so... Yeah, we're just going to go into it. We're hoping Johnny T and Austin Matthews can carry the team. You know, and I'm tired of seeing this. So I'm going to send you off to Russia, watch some World Cup games 6 weeks forward. See you later. Alrighty, leave me alone. Alrighty. 5-1-1 to start the season. Well, boyos, it's looking pretty good. 7-1-1. Oh, we lost to Carolina with Andrei Svechnikov. Oh, man, they're a team. Oh, here we go. Oh, we're on a bit of a losing streak here. Back-to-back versus Boston. We came out with one. There we go. We're back to it. We're back to it. Yeah. We lost a few, but we're back to our old ways. 8-2 win. What are we on? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 game winning streak. 6 game winning streak. Oh, we lost versus the Caps. You know what, boys? We'll lose about 3 in a row, 2 in a row, but if we're winning those 6 games in a row every here and there, then that's fine by me. You know what? Go draft my boy Max Paddock in the WHL. Maybe I'll draft him just for the fun. All right, boyos, we got our first trade offer here, and it kind of looks good. If it actually, honestly, like, it fits our team very well. So we're just gonna look, see what the trade value is looking like. Make sure we're not getting raped. So they want our first and fourth for Petrie. How's he doing? 82 overall. I thought he was a little better than that, to be honest. Top 4, 80. You know what? I'm going to wait till the trade deadline. Our team's playing good. We don't need anything right now. You know, we're just going to coast. We don't need to make any big accusations. Maybe a month before the trade deadline, because that way it gives the players a little more time to get to know each other, learn each other's game. And that's what I'd be more happy with. Because, like, we're honestly tearing it up right now. Like, no team can compete with this top two line. Maybe, like, Pittsburgh. As you can see, they did beat us. But, like, who else has got a 1-2 whammy punch like that? Like, nobody. Alright, so come January, I'm going to end the simulation as soon as we lose. Because we're unreal. Because I'm pretty sure the trade deadline is in February. Ah, fuck it. We'll just go to the trade deadline. Wait, so that's 30, 40, 44. We did lose one, but we're back to our winning ways here. Who are you? Salamaki? Nah, bud. Go to the minors. You're bad. Oh, boys. We're like, oh man, this team is amazing. All right, here we go. This is where I'm gonna make my trade, because I want to. Spezza and Stoner. What is Stoner like? Edit trade. Lucas Spezza, I don't like. He wasn't good in Vancouver. He wasn't that good in Vegas. He's good. He's just not that good. You know what I mean? And then Clayton Stoner. You know what, Vegas? Nice try. I'm going to have to say no to that one. I'm looking for a bit more in return. Let's take a look at the team, see how we're doing. Holy, we're at 20 minutes. Yeah, Johnny T, 26 goals, 24 points, 50 points in 53 games. Like, it doesn't get much better than that. Like, let's see how Matthews is doing. Hopefully he's not stunting too bad. Yeah, 37. See, this is why John Tavares gets the first line minutes. Like, Nylander, Marner, like, Matthews, you gotta step your game up when these two are playing better than you are. Like, time to get it up there, buddy. Like, Kadri's playing third line, and he's almost got as many points as you. Maybe I'll give you your own power play unit, see how that goes. Maybe I'll do that quickly right now. But honestly, boyos, our team is looking pretty dank. Like, we're running it over. Where did Thomas Plekanec come from? Who edited my lines? Who did this? You know what? Scratch player. Yeah. And then we're gonna bring Dominic Moore. Gross. Alright, who's coming in? Who's scratched? Oh, man. You know what? For the sake of the video, I don't care. Thomas Pekanik, you know, he's pretty irrelevant. He's got 18 points. Like, it's the same as any other third liner would do. Like, it's not like he's going to make a difference to our team. But the only thing I'm going to switch is he's going to play third line with Kadri. Just to spread out the talent, I'm going to drop down Nylander to help him out a little bit. As much as I want to play Kadri with Matthews, Kadri, we need that third line depth. Alright, so we're going to play Connor Brown on the right. There we go. That's the team. I don't know why it switched. It kind of triggers me a little bit. Martin Marcinen. Alright, so let's just look at this power play here. Yeah, I'm going to give this one to Matthews, and then I'm going to put Kadri with Tavares. Just to, like, as long as we got the clap on the one side. Shoots right. Yeah, so I'm going to switch these two so Marner has that clap. Yeah, there we go. That's how we're going to run it here, boys. And if it freaking changes, I'm going to be pissed. Alright, but we're looking for either a depth winger or Alex. Okay. Arizona wants to give away all of their defensemen. You know what we're looking at? These are amazing trades. These are just what we need. Like Kjalmarsson, Stanley Cup champion. He brings the experience. You know what I mean? He's honestly exactly what I'm looking for. He's got 2 goals, 1 assist. He's not playing well. He's not happy here in Arizona. You know what, boy? I'm gonna do it. He's a great defenseman. I know he is. He's got great passing. He's got great skating. You know, maybe not the greatest passing. Is he a defensive? Maybe I don't want him. Maybe Jason Demers is more our pace here, because we do need that offensive-minded defenseman. In Alex Goligoski. Yes. We're doing it. Boys, we're running it. Alright, Alex Goligoski, welcome to the team. Who are we going to give, though? You know what? Picks. People that, if anyone, like, complains about the pick here, like, we can afford him. It might screw us over long term. So we're going to try and get some retained salary going here. Arizona, you can afford it, so don't even complain. There we go. So we're getting Alex Goligoski 4 years for about $3 million per.
I think they'll take this. No? Do you want a little prospect too? Let's see what we got. Skaters matching block. See if they want it. See if they'll take Thomas Pekanik, because he's not supposed to be on the team anyway. And then we'll throw in an actual player that they probably want. Since we're picking up a defenseman, we can give a defenseman. We'll give our prospects. This is Dermott. There we go. Now they have too many skaters. Mechanics, come back. There you go. What do you mean you don't want to keep the salary? You're below the salary cap. You're you know what? Actually, boyos, if we keep this salary and then we give them Thomas Pekanik, because then that'll free up that salary anyway that we're not even supposed to have. So then that's pretty much just trade for trade. So I'm going to sauce in Thomas Pekanik because they want him. There. That has to go through, right? I feel like we're a little trade heavy on my side, but what? They didn't take that? Okay, we're going to slap in another depth pick. Because I don't know why they didn't take that pick. But we'll give them a fifth rounder as well. That's great value right there. They don't want him. I'm going to have to decline this offer, but I've agreed doing a good job on a proposal that would otherwise be considered fair value. Ultimately, however, considering the need this offer would address, we don't think it makes sense to take on the salary of Thomas Mechanic. He's got a 1 year! What do you mean? I'm so freaking confused right now. Oh, boyos. Alright, you know what? Alex Goligoski, we tried. I'm not giving up more than we have to. We'll come. Mark Giordano. Where's my boy Mark? Here we go. Oh, he's expensive. Nope.
Let's see what the Canucks are interested in giving away here. See, like Chris Tanev, 4.4. He's a defenseman. But his offensive capabilities aren't that bad. He's got an awesome shot. You know what? He's got like, where's my boy Alex? 2A defender. Offensive awareness, 84. You know what? He's put up like full career stats. He's put up points with the Sedins before. Like 42 points back in 2010. Like, he's a good defenseman. He knows how to do it. He knows how to get it done. Just about got 50 one year. Like, I think he's the guy for our squad. How many years does he have left? 2 years remaining. That's perfect. That gives us the opportunity when Matthews and all them are done. He fits our squad well. I can get him for a second rounder probably. Canucks want a second rounder. He fits the team. I think the Canucks will, this is a no-brainer for the organization. They're rebuilding. I think they take that. Yeah, awesome. You know what, boyos? That's a great trade for this team. I feel like that team, this trade is going to make this team a whole lot better. So I'm going to pop him into the lines here. Why does this keep changing? Okay, I think I put that assistant fucking coach on. And I need to take it off because it's making me mad. We're going to see what we can do. I want to pick up one more depth winger. Because that way I can get Dominic Moore down here. And I can just see if I can get Plekanec in the deal. I'll see if I can just trade him for a pick. Get him out of here. I'm pretty sure he went to Montreal. We'll see what Montreal has. Trade players. Ah! The Montreal Canadiens. There we go. You guys want Plekanec back? Please take him back. Why is he making so much money? That's my question. We're gonna see if we can make a deal with the Montreal because I want a bottom six forward. I need a depth guy. Kirby Reichel or Yuri Hudler. Perfect. Please take this trade. No. Alright. We're going to slap in a pick in there. Actually, what we're going to do is we're going to get rid of this pick and then we're going to add a pick. You know what? We're going all in, boyos. We're going to see if we can get a little more out of this. We're going to see if anybody... You know what? Let's look around for see who wants Plekanec and the first rounder. You know what? We're looking for the dump. Arizona wants them both. But they don't want to take on the cap. Alright. Well, we'll see if they change their minds. Who do we want here? So, overall, Richard Panik. You know what? I feel like that's honestly a perfect fit for our team. He's a Canadian boy, I'm pretty sure. Or no, he's not. He is not Canadian. He's from Slovak. That's funny. Anyway, Richard Panik, third line scoring forward. Offensive awareness is great. His shooting is really good. He scored like 30 goals the one year or some shit. 22 goals the other year. Then he went to Arizona and his life fell apart. Yeah, Richard Panik, boyos. I probably don't have to give a first for him. Probably keep our first rounder. Unless we want to go all in and find someone big. Because, you know what? I feel like it's their year. If we could find someone on a one-year contract, like a Jason Spezza. How about Michael Backlund? I like that one. Michael Backlund. See if they'll take this. They don't want Plekanec. Alright. Work with me, Calgary. Work with me here. I'm willing to dump picks on you. First, a third. I'll take a salary cap dump. A salary cap dump. Because we can afford it. What's Michael Frolik got left? 3 years? No. Yeah, I think we're going to take Matt Stajan off their hands too here. Or Christopher Stieg. Matt Stajan, just for the salary cap. Then we're going to give him a little prospects and this guy. And hopefully they accept that. Who do they want? You know, boyos, I'm throwing in the pick because I don't have time for this. There you go. You're going to have another second rounder. Oh, fuck. I still got to give him that prospect. There you go. Thank you. Alrighty, boys. It's time for Cup. Best roster. Here we go. I couldn't dump Mechanics, but I'm not going to play him in the team. He's just going to rot in the minors. So let me get this all set it up, sorted out, and I'll meet you guys on the other side here. Alrighty, boyos. I got the lines all sorted out here. I think this is how we're going to run it. Actually, never mind. Sorry, I got to fix this here. So you're going to play there. You're up here. So this is how we're going to rock the lines. We're going to do Johnny Tavares with Patrick Marleau and Mitch Marner on the first. We got Austin Matthews, William Nylander, and Nazem Kadri playing second line minutes now. We got Michael Backlund as the third line center for the squad with Zach Hyman and Connor Brown. Matt Martin, Matt Stajan, and Dale Weiss is our bottom line. And then we got Morgan Riley, Nikita Zaitsev, Jake Gardner, Alex Edler, Ron Hainsey, and Martin Mersinen. I think I want to play Connor Carrick. Actually, we're going to play Pollock just to get that defensive stacked back there. Just as that stay-at-home guy on the third line. And then our power play boyos. All right. Mitchell Marner on the left side with the right-handed shot for that snipe upstairs. Alex Ovechkin style with John Tavares and Nazem Kadri. Second line, we got Matthews, Nylander, and Backlund running that one. So, fair to say, it's pretty scary. Actually, I think I'm going to just slap a little... I'm going to slap a forward on the top here. Who's not up there? We're gonna put Marleau here. We're gonna put him on that side, so he has the clap if he wants it. Left, left, right, right. And a lot of lefties on this, but I don't think that matters all too much. Yeah. So that's how we're gonna run the rest of the season. Let's see how it goes. No more trades. We made our trades. We're running it now, boyos. We're gonna sim all the way through to the end of the season. And now I want you to go scout my boy Riley Lamb, Red Deer Rebels, baby. Oh, boys, we just win games now, don't we? Oh, the Leafs are overpowered. Decline. We don't want your shit. Oh, we can't be stopped. We're too good, boyos. Too good. This isn't fair. That's what I want. I don't want fairness. I want championships. You know what? I'm just the best player. I'm just the best GM player ever. You know what? I don't know why teams are so against trading their future picks. They're just dumb. It's like, oh, you want to win the cup? Then give away your picks. You don't need them. You're winning cups. Like, get out of here. Let's get to 50 wins, boyos. Oh, come on! Six more. We gotta beat Tampa. There's one. Ah! Two. Ah! Three. Ah! Two more. 50 wins. Let's go. 50 wins. Let's go. Ah, come on. We gotta win our last two. Replace this player. Ah, we couldn't get to 50 wins, boys. Did it freeze? No! Fuck off! Well, I don't fucking care if we win the fucking Stanley Cup now because it fucking froze.
fucking subscribe if you fucking enjoyed. See you guys in the fucking next one. Peace. This only took fucking half an hour. More like a fucking hour and a half. Fuck's sakes. Fuck! Subscribe if you enjoyed, guys. Peace.